Hey everybody, it's Paul here at Gillette Castle State Park. Today I'm standing down by the Connecticut River. Now just a 30-second walk north of the Chester Hadline Ferry Landing, we have the area that I'm standing over right now. Today I'm here so I can talk to you about one of Gillette's many hobbies, and that would be boating. Now his first boat was called the Holy Terror, and then around 1900 he had another boat built called the Aunt Polly. Originally it was about 102 feet long, and then a couple years later he got it extended by about 40 feet. Now, it was named after Polly Caruth. Now, the story is that when Gillette was living down in North Carolina in the 1890s, he was exploring the mountains and suddenly became ill. He could not go on. And Aunt Polly was a mountain woman in the area who happened to find Gillette when he was ill. She brought him back to her house, nursed him back to health, and he was very appreciative for that. So he named his boat after her, or at least that's what the legend is. Now, he used the Aunt Polly to go everywhere. It was mainly docked out of Greenport, Long Island, but he went across the Long Island Sound, the Connecticut River. He went all over the Northeast coastline. The story is that one day in 1913, William Gillette was taking the Aunt Polly on a pleasure cruise up the Connecticut River. He stopped for the night over by the ferry landing, and the next day he hiked up the hill. He noticed how amazing the view is from up top there, and that is what made him want to build his retirement home, his castle here on the Seventh Sister Hill. He was still using the Aunt Polly quite a bit. He would spend a lot of his time during the summers living on it. When the castle was still under construction, if he was here, he'd be able to stay on the boat and just go up and check on the progress of the castle. And then around 1924, it started springing some leaks, so they put it in a semi-permanent mooring here down by the river. Now, you fast forward to about 1932, the Aunt Polly actually caught fire. Now, the cause of the fire is unknown even to this day. A lot of people speculated that Gillette may have actually set fire to it himself so he could collect the insurance money, but he squashed that rumor pretty quickly because he put out a letter to the editor in the local paper thanking everyone for their concern about him after the fire and assuring them that he didn't set fire to it himself. And he explained that the boat wasn't insured. He didn't think of it at the time, so he wouldn't have been able to collect any money from it anyway. Even though the boat burnt down in 1932, it's still very much visible today. So for example, where I'm standing right now, this is the site of the wreckage. So you can actually see that the keel of the ship is extending pretty far into the water. There's also a lot of bolts hanging out in the sand here. There's storage tanks where you can see the metal outlines. You can see valves sticking out all from the Aunt Polly. So it's definitely a cool place to check out. This is marked on the trail map. So I definitely encourage you to come and take a look. But obviously be mindful, be respectful, because it's really cool, but it's still an archaeological site, and we want to make sure that it stays preserved as best as it can. So if you want to look at it, that's awesome, but make sure you don't take anything. Make sure that you be careful, because there is also quite a bit of metal sticking out of the ground here. But it is definitely pretty awesome. And you probably remember seeing a lot of the items from the Aunt Polly when we showed you the Aunt Polly room up in the castle. If you don't remember, check out the first half of the second floor tour video, and you'll be able to catch up on some of that too. So that's what I have to talk to you about today. Make sure you keep liking our videos. Feel free to post any comments or questions you might have, and make sure you keep sharing them with all of your friends and family so that everyone can enjoy the video content that we have to offer. So take care, and we'll see you guys again soon. Bye.